Welcome back. Welcome to Download.
Thank you very much.
We finally made it.
Yeah, well, we played Download France, but it's not the same thing, I guess.
No. So we're going to start off with this.
And then I have to do the interview with that in my mouth.
Yeah, you can put it in and introduce yourself.
Are there gluten inside?
No, look, gluten free.
I only like stuff with gluten.
Oh.
Yeah, so I'm sorry. I cannot eat that.
you don't sing. Oh, well, you do, but not in a mic.
I'm already happy it's not peppers. Fucking sour it is. It makes me look evil. So what do you want?
Introduce yourself.
Oh, fuck it.
It's Coen from Epica.
I'm Coen from Epica. And I have a sour thing in my mouth.
It's nice to talk to you because I always get Mark.
Yeah.
I'm bored of Mark now.
Well, I have basically the same last name, so.
Oh, really?
You're used to this, right? Because I.
Yeah.
Why don't you take one too?
Okay, I'm not done one today. Although it does make me.
This is going to be so good online. Oh, man.
Okay, yeah. I think I burnt off on my Facebook.
Oh, I'm going to cry. It's an emotional day for me.
It's all right. You can cry that out. So you have the most awesome keyboard setup. I really like your keyboard on the wheel.
Thank you. Actually, we only play half an hour today.
Mm.
So I wasn't aware that we brought it. But then suddenly they said, yeah, we're bringing the whole truck with the whole setup. And
oh, wow.
I said, yeah, I can roll around, lose some calories.
Mm. What interests me is because it spins the 360.
Yeah.
So how's it attached?
It's magic, pure magic.
Yeah. Yeah. How do you get power and the signal out?
It's awesome magic, you know. I load myself up with static electricity, and whenever I play, it conveys to the keyboard. Well, it's just a battery underneath.
I swallowed.
Oh. Mine actually now turns sweet because all the sour is off. You take one too. No.
Did you have one yesterday?
No, it's actually pretty nice. Mm. If I chew on it, then it explodes in sour again.
There's sherbet, but it's not sour. Mm. But it's hard. Don't care for your teeth.
Yeah.
So, and breathe. Yeah.
So what did you want to know?
Yeah, that was it. Just the keyboard.
Yeah, no, it's a battery underneath, and everything is wireless. I even have a wireless sustain pedal. But we had to kind of invent it because it wasn't available. Mm. So we have a great guitar tech who actually builds a lot of our stuff. Right. And he built this as well with a lot of new stuff. We have to take a mega sour gluten-free lemon stuff, and then you have to talk. Mine is sweet now. This is Isaac, by the way. He is our guitar player.
And
he's going to cry in 15 seconds. But it's gluten-free.
And vegan.
Well, I need to go.
Good luck with that. Hey, no.
Guitar Tech was building it.
Yeah, he built. He actually had to take a laptop battery, extra battery, and convert it into something that my keyboard can handle, and then build it to have my sustain pedal powered as well. And then all the other stuff goes with wireless MIDI. Oh man, if somebody uses a cell phone on stage, I'm fucked.
Oh yeah.
No, it was in the beginning, but now it's okay.
Mm. So it must be nice as a keyboard player. It's typically static. You get to move around.
Yeah, it's really nice. It all started with the spinning one, but then everybody did that. I wasn't the first one anyway. But I thought a long time about having a rails to move around. And then last cycle, we thought about actually doing it because, you want to create a cool stage show. And it's a lot of fun, I can tell you that. Yeah.
That's one thing that can be said about Epica. Is that you're all enjoying being on stage. You're not just entertaining the audience, you're entertaining yourselves.
Yeah, and I acted like a spoiled kid, so I don't want to be static. I want to move around without having an ugly guitar.
Mm. And I was just going to say, you also have
a super cool guitar.
Does it count as a guitar?
It's
curved.
Yeah, it's a curved MIDI controller. Yeah.
Mm. Which is also pretty cool.
And I can actually crowd surf with it, but I don't think we have the proper song to do it today.
Have you crowd surfed?
Of course.
Wow.
I crowd surf with it, yeah.
Nice.
It's great. Is it allowed here on download?
I think officially no, but yeah, I think there's probably a song.
No, but no, normally there's this one song where there's the perfect spot to do it, you know, without too difficult parts to play and where I have time to actually get back on stage. But now we only have half an hour and I don't want to hold the set back, so maybe I run to the front if the stage isn't too high, but that's about it.
Yeah, it's pretty high.
It is?
Yeah. You're on second stage?
Yeah, the Zippo thingy.
Yeah.
Well, you know, we had stages where I jumped off and my tech was too afraid to follow because it was too high. So and then I had to run all the way back. You know, I missed the half of the next song.
But you got in his, so.
Yeah. Everything is wireless. Yeah, it's really cool.
So for those who don't know Epica, describe your music in three words.
Epic symphonic metal.
Yeah. Perfect.
Yeah.
What would you say is the go-to track to check out of yours?
Sorry?
The go-to track to check out if someone doesn't know you, what should they listen to?
Oh, I would say maybe Cry for the Moon, but that's like 16 years old already, but that's our most viewed song. I would say maybe Beyond the Matrix from our latest album, which is a really good festival banger. We're going to probably have the whole crowd jump. But you can check out, it goes from slow piano ballads, like delicate stuff, to really heavy stuff with only guitars and grunts. So, you know, go check it out. It's Spotify. It's easy. You know, you don't have to buy it anymore. Just listen to it. It's easy. Yeah.
And Epic Metal Fest, is that going to come back?
Well, we hope so. Maybe in a few years. But like a few years back, we did this show and then we thought, should we make it Epic Metal Fest again or should we call it Epica with guest artists? And actually, the promoters prefer the latter, so fuck sour again.
But no, that's nice.
maybe in a year or so when we all start up again, we're gonna do that. But
I think you did a good year to not do it because Arian did his show, didn't he?
Yeah, but he's doing it again this year.
Yeah.
Actually, Mark and Simone are joining him.
Mm. Which I went to your last Epic Metal Fest, but I didn't get to go to the Arian show.
We actually did a song with Arian a few months back with the Metropole Orchestra. I didn't know if you heard it.
Oh, no.
We did a really awesome version of Beyond the Matrix with jazz and big band parts in it.
Okay.
Yeah, it's never heard before, so you should check that one out.
Okay, on YouTube.
Yeah.
Oh, cool.
Beyond the Matrix with the Metropole Orchestra. Nice. And Arian did a guest solo on it. Really nice. Wow.
You got him to perform.
Of course. We're all friends in the Netherlands.
Oh, yeah, but he doesn't like to play, does he?
No, he does like to play, but not live. He hates to play live. Mm. He's very nervous, apparently, which I don't know why, because he makes awesome music. But
In fact, actually, I saw him at your show. Is that him?
Yeah, it could be. Yeah, I actually never spoken with him, which I hate, because apparently sometimes he has guest musicians on his albums.
Yeah. Need to get in on that.
No, but he has mostly his keyboards are done by Joost, who does our productions. Phenomenal player, phenomenal guy, so I wouldn't stand in issues. Like, it's like asking Jordan Rudess to move over to play on Dream Theater albums, right? So you don't do that stuff.
Well, on his last album, he did do some parts himself. I think there's room.
There's always room, maybe.
Yeah.
Maybe he asks me someday.
I'm sure you could do a solo at least.
Yeah.
Cool.
Who knows?
Well, it's been great to talk to you. Are you going to catch any bands today?
I wish. But we have to get on a stupid boat later this evening. So we arrived this morning and then I saw all the bands playing. Like, I really wanted to see the Antwoord, which is fucking great. And you never play on the same festival because it's not really a metal act. And then they start at 6:40, I guess, and we leave at 6. It's always the same.
Damn.
Of course, I wanted to see Slipknot and Hailstorm would be great. But unfortunately, it's not going to happen.
The pros and cons of being a festival band.
Yeah.
So next up, next year, hopefully. Finally,
well, no, next year you're not in the EU anymore, so we can't come anymore. It's all going to be shut down and closed and terrible and crying. And
there is that.
Yeah, you should all come to Holland then.
But if you fly?
I don't know. We'll see.
It's a smaller stage at Bloodstock.
Bloodstock would be cool. Yeah, we play there like 9 years ago or something?
That's it. No, wow. You're well overdue. Way overdue.
But we did some proper shows in London. And then you probably say, oh, London, it's not the UK or all London.
Oh, yeah, but you've started expanding because you did Nottingham last year. Last year?
Well, the other guy said we skipped Nottingham. So I can't remember anyway.
No, you did play Nottingham.
Well, yeah, okay.
Rock City.
Awesome. I probably remember the venue if I step in, but for now I can't remember.
Yeah, so you did, I think, about 5 or 6, 7 dates last time.
Yeah.
Whereas the last few years you've been doing the one London date.
I remember we played Ireland for the first time.
Oh, yeah?
That was cool.
Nice.
I'll always remember the first time in a new country.
Okay.
It's great, yeah.
Cool. Well, I shall let you get on, anyway. Great to talk to someone other than Mark.
Yeah, well, you can always call me.
Okay.
I'm in the phone book, so...
All right. Thank you.
Yeah, you're welcome.